The Israeli Deputy Prime Minister Shaul Mofaz is here in Washington for high-level talks right now with the Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and other Obama administration officials. Iran's nuclear program certainly is atop their agenda. During an interview, I asked Shaul Mofaz if Israel was concerned about Iranian retaliation for the reports that Israel and the United States have undertaken joint cyber warfare attacks against Iran's nuclear program.
Well, we have to be prepared for all kind of cyber attack against the state of Israel.
He said Israeli military action was certainly on the table.
We have to be prepared for all options, but at the same time, I believe that there are other ways to stop the Iranian nuclear program.
He expressed hope that severe international sanctions that are supposed to begin next month will work.
And from my perspective, the military option is the last option.
But it is an option. Would it be an Israeli option or a U.S. option or a joint military option?
It is an option. The U.S. should prepare it. Israel should prepare it. And from my point of view, I believe that it should be by the leadership of the United States. And I see the prevention of an Iranian nuclear program as the acid test of Obama administration.
On Syria, Mofaz minced no words.
I believe that Bashar al-Assad is a dictator that leading a genocide against his people. He's slaughtering his people. He's slaughtering innocent people within Syria, and he will not survive.
Eventually, he said, there will be massive desertions in the Syrian military.
This is the end of Bashar al-Assad.
On Egypt, Mofaz expressed hope that the Muslim Brotherhood presidential candidate, Mohamed Morsi, would honor Egypt's peace treaty with Israel.
He was very moderate during the campaign, and I hope that he understands the importance of the relationship with Israel and the fact that we have to safeguard the peace agreement between us.